The CDC has put out some new guidelines on travel, testing, and the length of quarantines. We have WMR2 News Aaron McPherson live at Penn Station with that part of the story. Good morning, Aaron.
Good morning, Christian. Well, the CDC would prefer you not to travel, but they know some people will do so regardless. Thanksgiving was proof of that, so they just want to make sure that people are as safe as possible. They say traveling on trains, planes, or buses have a much higher risk of exposure than driving to your destination, especially if you are driving with someone you live with or driving by yourself. And if you do plan on traveling, when you get to your destination, avoid social gatherings, being in crowds, maintain proper social distancing, wear your mask, and wash your hands often, especially if you have to stop in public places. And before you go, think about getting your flu shot. Check travel restrictions for your destination as well as the stops in between. And the CDC is recommending you get two COVID tests if you do travel. The first 1 to 3 days before you go, and again 3 to 5 days after you get back. Plus, avoiding non-essential activities for a week after is ideal. The CDC also revised their quarantine guidelines, saying quarantine can end 10 days after exposure with no symptoms and no COVID test, but can end after 7 days if you had exposure, no symptoms, and a negative test. These restrictions are less than the original 14-day recommendation. Not a major change, but the CDC is hopeful this will encourage people to follow their guidelines a little more since it's a less amount of time and less of a burden. And health officials are constantly learning more about this virus, so they are updating their regulations and guidelines. We will keep you updated on these recommendations and changes, but ultimately, they do advise you to stay home. Live here in Baltimore, Aaron McPherson, WMAR 2 News.